Rotational blackouts again continue to hit parts of Luzon as the power grid in the island remains under red alert status for the third straight day. The red alert status has been in effect since 9 in the morning and will last until 5 o'clock this afternoon. It will also again be raised between 6 p.m. and 11 p.m. tonight. The rotational power interruptions are due to a continuous deficit in power plants. The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines warns the power situation in Luzon grid may last until next week. Authorities blamed a power deficit on high demand due to the humid weather and maintenance works. But a progressive group questions why government seemed unprepared for the power problem.
Ang rotating brownouts ay labis na pabigat lalo na sa mga estudyante natin na may online classes at mga magulang na work from home ang moda. Secretary Cusi nasa Cebu kahapon para unahin ang politika sa PDP laban sa halip na unahin ng power shortage. Kaya labis na nakakadismaya.
As for Senate Energy Committee Chairman Sherwin Gatchalian, he fears the power outages will affect the country's vaccine rollout.
Noong Abril, nagkaroon kami ng pagdinig dito para tanungin ang Department of Energy kung ano ang sitwasyon natin pagdating sa kuryente. Nabigyan kami ng assurance na hindi magkakaroon ng brownout. Kinakabahan ako magiging sanhi ng delay at baka tumaas rin yung tinatawag nating vaccine hesitancy dahil marami ayaw pumunta doon dahil mabagal, mainit.
The Philippine Energy Department is studying the possibility of filing charges against certain power suppliers for economic sabotage. Undersecretary Felix Fuentabella says power suppliers that may have carried out preventive maintenance during the months of April, May, and June violated the agency's rules, causing power interruptions in the Luzon grid. The DOE is asking suppliers to submit their maintenance schedules to the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines. It is also checking whether suppliers have energy reserves that can be tapped for distribution.
So, whether all these were violated or complied with, we are gathering the pieces of evidence because ano ba gusto ng Department of Energy penalty ba? Hindi. Ang gusto natin compliance. Pero kung patuloy ang hindi pag-comply, wala tayong magagawa kundi we have to impose the discipline that is necessary because at the end of the day, consumers are suffering.